I'm heading 300 miles to the northeast to view a classic motorsport engine. It's rare, and there could be money to be made.
This one happens to be a Pinto. Now, Pintos are very popular motorsport engines used in the 1970s, particularly in Ford.
With a reputation for rugged reliability, the compact four-cylinder Pinto could be tuned for road or track. It had huge racing success in the 1960s and 70s. Many were driven to destruction, so now they're thin on the ground. So classic motorsport enthusiasts, especially Ford drivers, are always on the lookout for running engines.
Whoa, there is some stuff in here. Look at this place.
Hello.
Hey, how you doing, Gordon? You
all
right, mate?
You all right?
Good to see you. Good. Where's this engine?
There it is there, mate.
This one round here?
Yep.
What can you tell me about it?
It came out of a kit car. It's got a stage 3 head. It's also got oversized pistons in it. So it's around, I would say, 2.1, if not a little bit over.
Okay, so it's had a ton of work done to the inside. And it's had some work done to the outside as well, because that rocker cover, that's not standard, is it? Could they be changed?
Yeah, I've got a cover here.
Yeah, so it should have that rocker cover with it. It should be like that, shouldn't it?
Yeah.
So, how much is it?
£1,750.
What, like, just for the engine? £1,750, you're describing a car for £1,750. You want £1,750 just for an engine?
It comes with the parts also. I've a nice set of carburetors here.
Right, OK.
I'm keeping my cool. It's a good negotiating ploy, but actually, I'm rather excited by this engine. I know parts like the twin carburetors, they're worth £500 just on their own.
Would you take £1,250 for it?
I couldn't, mate. I couldn't.
Seriously?
It would cost more money to build one, to tell you the truth.
So what would you take for it? What's your best price?
£1,550.
£1,550? £1,500.
If you take it today, yes.
I'll take it right now.
Deal.
Did I just do that?
You did. You've got yourself a good engine.
It may, at the moment, look like a box of bits, but trust me, once I give that to my Formula One engine specialist, Elvis, he'll soon have that Pinto galloping.
Engine could be worth between £2,000 and £3,000. This one is cheap because it's in bits and I can't hear it running. So I'm taking a gamble that it's going to be okay.
Well, I've got something a little bit different for you today. Not a car. This is for you to play with.
Wow, that's a Pinto engine, isn't it? But it's not standard, is it? Because there's a couple of bits that are different.
Don't worry, I've got another rocker cover, which is the right one. To go on the top.
Look at that. It's also the wrong colour, isn't it? I mean, that's not how they were out the box.
No, it should be blue.
I mean, what's the plan with this?
It's basically tidy it up, fix it up, paint it, and I'm aiming to double the money.
Double what money? How much do you pay for it?
£1,500.
Does it run?
I've never seen it run.
Well, I love Mike's optimism. It's got some great bits in it, it's got some expensive parts in it, that's brilliant, but until I hear it running and purring away like a proper motorsport engine should, I just won't be happy. OK, so this is the crankshaft. So it does look like it's been recently rebuilt. All moving as it should. You can see the pistons going up and down, nice and cleanly in the bores. You can get kind of build-ups of deposits of bits of metal that have ground off over the years. Haven't got any of that. The oil that you can see, the residue, looks pretty clean, which is great, because that shows it hasn't done an awful lot of miles since it went in. But it does actually look to be in pretty good condition. Making some great noises too. Really pleased, good start. Since the 1960s, the signature colour of Ford Motorsport engines has always been blue, so I'm going to repaint this one in the right shade as part of our sales strategy to appeal to fast Ford fans. Artist at work. These engines are becoming rarer and rarer, so it's actually quite nice to be able to work on one. And whilst it's nostalgic for me, I actually think the value in these things for potential buyers will be in its originality and its authenticity. So I think the things we're doing will all be adding value to the engine for somebody. There we go. That blue looks awesome. So now that the engine is painted, we can put it back together. And the first job is to get this rocker cover replaced with this nice original one. To do that, we need to put a new gasket on, which seals between the rocker cover and the engine block itself. And whenever I'm doing this, I don't use a gasket sealant, which can be really sticky, and if you ever need to take it apart, can actually tear the gasket when you pull the rocker cover off. So I use grease, which is much more manageable, much more usable, but does a similar job. The fact that the carb's got four barrels under here, one for each of the cylinders, allows each cylinder to have its own fuel supply, and essentially we're able to force more fuel and air mixture into the engine, generating more power. Which is exactly why this is perfect for a motorsport setup.
Right then.
All right,
here's that battery you ordered.
Thank you.
It's looking so good, that engine, it really is.
Yeah, it looks nice, doesn't it? And I think we're pretty much ready to give this a little spin over.
That's not good at all.
But let me just double check all of these.
I haven't bought a Duff engine, have I?
I hope it's just that these massive carbs just haven't filled up with enough fuel yet. I mean, they're huge. They need an awful lot of fuel to get these things going, so maybe it just hasn't pulled enough in yet.
Come on, baby, please start. Oh, yes. Come on, baby. Woo-hoo!
We're nearly there.
Yes! Yeah! Oh, yes! I mean, what a relief.
Wow. Sounds good, right?
I reckon me and you are going to turn this into a wicked profit.
I love it.
Well done.
Race ready.
This engine has been built for racing, so I focus my ads on the motorsport forums with a price of £2,600. I've listed the entire specification, as this audience will want to know every last detail of what's been done to it.
I've received an email off a guy called Lewis. He's interested in my Pinto engine. However, he's a sailor and is currently in the Mediterranean working. So he's booked a ship-to-shore radio call and he wants me to talk him through the engine in the hope that he wants to buy it. Is that you, Lewis?
Yes, thank you.
I'm standing here staring at the most beautiful Pinto engine.
Okay, fantastic.
This one's lovely. It's got the 45mm Dell'Auto carbs, stage-free head, it's ported and polished, and it's ready to go.
Right.
Lewis wants an engine for his Mark 1 Escort project car. I included tons of detail and close-up photos in my ad, so although Lewis can't see it in the flesh, he should still be in a good position to make me an offer.
What are you asking for the engine?
So £2,600 is where I need to be.
Right, I can do that, sounds like the perfect.
Lovely, that is fantastic, Lewis. I'll put this one sold and down to you.
Fantastic.
Super, thanks, Lewis.
Bye.
Nice one. Click here to subscribe.